Welcome to another episode of Halo Wars. On my team, you have myself, you have Fusion Left playing as the Brute, and you have Capitan Cutter playing as the Arbiter. On the opposite team, you have Patrick playing as Anders, QB Ghost playing as the Brute, and you have the best Arbiter in the game, Thought Elm, playing as the Arbiter.
Supply pad complete. Yes,
sir. So we were playing the other day, and Fusion Lift kept readying up Brute, and yes, Thought Elm kept readying up Arbiter. So eventually we all just local went RB Brute, random UNSC every game.
Local units.
On this day, Fusion Lift was drunk. It was a pain in the ass playing with Fusion. He would always get making mistakes for both teams. We played about 8 games, and I think he only won about 2 games. And we were playing random teams, so like we were just skipping around. And you can see QB Ghost right away is pushing with his Ghost and just annoying the fuck out of me. Not letting me pick up the money like I want to pick it up, which... I mean, it's really, it is a strong strat. I mean, I like talking shit about Thought Elm, but you can't deny that. I mean, that is annoying as fuck. I'm not sure if my own teammates doing the same thing. It doesn't look like they are doing the same thing. I personally would not have done that if I were Thought Elm, though, because let's say he pushes up with his Ghost and my Brute rushes, right? You see on their side of the map, they're way across from each other. So the Arbiter is not going to get all the money that he needs to make to raise down Brutes.
Watching your vicious bastard die gave me more relief than 1,000 lying whores.
Right there you see his, because he has to raise so much to get to the Brute. Even though my Brute didn't go grunts, my Brute most likely went inheritance. But even though that happened, he didn't pay attention to his Ghost and he lost it to the Rebels. So that means there should be a lot of money left over on their side, because it's only been the Warhogs and the Chopper picking up the money.
Local units.
Right here, I'm just going to try and help Capitan Cutter get this Brute off with my hurt Warhogs. And I am bruised. I just wish I don't really see any of their scouts on the map. There should be some money left on their side of the map. That Ghost should really be up there. I don't know if it's dead or what it's doing. But that UNSC is going to get a lot of money, which is not the best for us. Right here, I'm just trying to... because a lot of my Warhogs got hurt, I can't really go in with all my Warhogs, so... I'm just taking damage on my Warhawks, too much damage, and I can't go in to force a grunt in, but at least I've been putting pressure on the Brute, and apparently we've done a better job than they have, because here in a second I'm going to look at our Brute, and it looks like we have a lot more health. Our Brute has a lot more health than their Brute, and with this kind of, whenever this is going on, you really, really want to get their Brute off of your base. Before they get your own Brute off of theirs, you know, it's a race to see who can push off the Brute off faster without taking too much damage. So apparently he gets him to recall or something, because he's gonna go up on offense, so that's a big win for us. But UNSC wise, I am way behind right now, because all the damage I've taken, I think I've lost like 2 Warhogs. I have a couple more very bruised up Warhogs. And on top of that, I didn't pick up all the crates that their UNSC is going to get local, because their Ghost pushed up, and ours might have pushed up too, but not like theirs did. So our Brute recalled, he was probably about to get grunted, and he's going to go back on offense. I have my expansion cleared, and I think as an Anders, you always want to help to push off the Brute. Then once he's pushed off, clear the Rebels. But as Scudder, I like clearing the base and then clearing the Rebels. I just feel like with Cutter, it's important to get that base up as fast as possible because it's instantly stationed and it's harder to deny. And it also gives them one more thing to worry about. Like right there, that arbiter, he could have pushed my shit, denied my base, but he chose to go to my covenant. I'm not saying he should have done that, but let's say he did go deny my expo, then my brute doesn't get those two pads tonight. And it's kind of better for us. However, I do not like that my brute just got stripped like that. He just got put on two pads, so that really sucks. I was about to debomb the arbiter. Our arbiter is at their arbiter's base. He probably should have like not let that happen, to be honest. He should have like been close to the front, because we did get their brute off faster than theirs, only by a few seconds. But enough to where he could have made it to that base, and he probably could have blocked those brutes. And now their brute is playing defense. Now I got my expansion up. I took the money already, so I'm gonna go to the middle. And I am going to clear the money in the middle. I see that their brute is about to push on over, and I catch him, and he's like, hell no, I ain't doing that. So he instantly recalls. Not only that, but my arbiter catches Warhogs, Anders Warhogs. So he killed quite a few Warhogs of Anders, which is great for us, because now that I have an expo, it's just gonna be an even bigger lead. Because, well, I assume he's gonna go off Gods for one base. He might have taken an expansion. I don't know if he did or not. But the fact that he just got a few Warhogs, and as an Anders, I like going single base Gods most of the time. Our Brute, however, is still slightly behind, so I give Fusion a lot of shit, but
I need healing.
This game, he is going to do the right thing. Right there, he asked me for a heal, and now my Arbiter asked me for a heal, and I want to heal my Warhog, so I guess my teammate just thinks I'm made of heals right here or something. Our Arbiter is definitely ahead.
Enemy spotted.
Run, bitch! Run!
As you can see, I've lost two Warhogs. No, one. I lost one Warhog. About to probably lose a second one there. One to the Vortex, and the Arbiter kind of. The Arbiter on their team is really broke compared to our Arbiter. Our Arbiter is way ahead. However, their Brute is ahead of ours, and this is where I gotta give Fusion some props. Even though he's been throwing all game. Well, not all game, but he was throwing this whole day a lot. Right here, he's gonna play a really good defense on their Brute, which their Brute has got a scary hog going on. And I'm not really willing to go in yet until my Goss is up. You see their Arbiter, our Arbiter. Their Arbiter is broke, though, so we can't really afford to rage. And I know this, so I'm just waiting for like a good chance, and I see that they split up. Their Arbiter split up from their Brute, so I'm just gonna go ahead and try and get him off even before I get Goss, because I see that he's half health. And here you see Fusion playing a really good defense with Jackals stopping their haul. And here I catch the Arbiter by myself.
Fatality.
That's Thaddeum rip number two this game. No, that's rip number one. That's the first time he dies this game. I'm gonna be turning up a lot into Thaddeum this game. I don't know why. I just feel like talking shit about him. I just feel like ripping into him because he is the self-proclaimed best 3v3 player in the game or something like that. Number one Arbiter in the game. And he keeps saying that, so I'm just gonna give him some shit for it. So now
local units,
our Brute is going back up, and I assume he was going back up to keep haul rushing.
Research.
But apparently after he pushed off that haul, he switched to air, which sort of I feel like he should just stay hall. I mean, why not? You're already going hall. So, we're going to go up. Well, I'm going to find a brute here and push him off again. I had a lot of good luck this game, pushing off leaders, coming through a teleporter. There's our brute chieftain. And I'm just going to see that the Warhawks are going to play defense on him. So I'm going to take this opportunity to go to the other side and just snipe the Anders Expos. Because obviously Anders has weaker Expos compared to like Cutter. So I'm just going to go in and start taking out that Expo. But I am afraid of a Cryo, and they do have an Arbiter. So I'm just going to... Our brute's been pushed off. I'm more afraid of a Cryo. So he's definitely thinking about cryoing right here. So I'm just going to go get out because for this position, just leaving a couple of Warhawks back just to make sure. And I leave, and at this point we put their Anders on either one or two bases. At the moment I thought it was two bases, but I wasn't sure. And I see that my brute recall, and I just heal him. That's just my instinct. I'm gonna heal your full tech one chieftain. However, that was probably not the best idea because he's switching into air, and I didn't know. Still, like, I just now started realizing he's switching into air. I see my arbiter is running to a teleporter, so I'm gonna run there. If he goes through, I can maybe get the catch on. Some of these units, I honestly wish he would have just recalled. So I wish I would have used that heal on other heal on the arbiter and my Warhawks. And here I'm gonna make a mistake. I see that my brute is walking that way again. There's no reason for my brute to walk that way again. He probably should have went to the other side, but I mean, I just have the instinct of sticking with my team. Because like that's one of the rules of war, bro. When like you keep your fucking forces together. In the engagements, you can split up whenever you're not fighting. All units. But whenever you fight, you want to have the biggest amount of firepower. You know, it's that's like one of Sun Tzu's, the Chinese war general. Like that's one of the oldest rules of war. However, they have a big ass hall, and we do not. We went straight into Tech 2 Banshees, and we're just now getting Banshees. Which they're pretty good, but not yet. In the short term, they have a big ass haul that can almost hold off our all three of us together. When we should have just pushed to the other side. And right here, I'm realizing this, but I'm realizing this a little bit too late because I see that they're already over here. Now Patrick's probably on three bases. I made a bad choke point, so I'm trying to get myself in the best position possible. And I'm gonna fight. And my arbiter is almost in front of the UNSC base. I do not know why, so I'm being left alone against the Warhawks. Well, I'm not completely alone. I have Fusion helping me Vortex, but our Arbiter should really not win up there. So their Arbiter is going to recall. My Arbiter is going to come down. However, like we already lost a shit ton of units, and now their own Brute is Vortexing my stuff.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
So yeah, that is not good. I just lost everything. They have a big ass haul coming up. I see this right here. I see that only has two pads, so I just mac it. I was in the hopes that I could get away down the side. Here comes Fusion Banshees, which they are repeating cannon, so that is good. He's been holding off so to keep them from building bands, but I am gonna get these few Warhawks caught. And I've lost so many Warhawks. We lost the Arbiter. And I'm just gonna try and gather up as many Warhawks and before their inevitable push, because you know they're out for blood now. So at least I know how many bases their units he has. I see that base by their brute is not cleared. So I got four bases to his two. So I just gotta wait for my arbiter to come out.
Local units.
I'm trying to rebuild my population back up. Their brute's coming up with that big ass hall. And there's no plan defense on that hall. If they're all three gonna push together, there's no point in playing defense on that. I tell my arbiter to just throw up the shield, and we're gonna counter push. I am catching up in Warhawk numbers right now. I have about 15 on the field, a few more building. And I'm just gonna have to sack that base. This is one of the good things about being Cutter. Well, I think Cutter later game is almost as good as Handers. And I say almost, the only reason it is not is because of the cryo bomb. The cryo bomb single-handedly makes Handers the best leader at going Gauss. But I do feel like Cutter is almost as good, especially like after you do get it. If Anders doesn't get Gauss like super quick and messes you up, then Cutter becomes good because of the station bases. It becomes really good at base trading as well. Whenever games like this where we all decide to base trade. The only good thing about Fusion, like holding off to his Banshees and like just going straight into repeating cannon, is that I don't think they ever saw it coming. I don't think their other team ever realized that we had Banshees. So Fusion's almost close to a full bop of Banshees. He's got a substantial amount. And here we can see that Patrick's still only on two bases. Well, I'm even though I lost a base, I'm still on three. I think I just had a lot more Warhogs than he realized I was gonna have. So he just comes in red bar and he's just gonna die instantly. We're gonna catch all of Patrick's. The benches are gonna come in. And we're gonna just kill this base. As you can see, he was just now starting to throw the summit up. You know, for the best arbiter in the game, he could have had a summit already in a few vamps, you know?
Local units. Local units.
¿Qué te ríes? ¿De que llegaste tarde a la repartición de cerebros?
Bye bye, Thought Elm. So even though the game is basically over, the enemy team is already, they're gonna fight through. And I feel like I can defend and save my expos at the very least. Fusionlift wanted me to keep pushing, but I'm just gonna mac the base for him. He can finish it off. They have no way of defending it. I take a base on their side.
All units.
Leroy Dragons!
All units.
Captain Cutter got a little bit eager there. Now he needs a heal.
I need healing.
This game is basically over. The other team refuses to throw in the towel. I just wanted to make a video ripping on Thought Elm a little bit. I don't got nothing against him. I just have a little bit of fun. He's such a big troll. He's always talking about how he's the best. He's always playing by the book, which I'm still looking for this book. I haven't found the book. Apparently Metalloid Monkey wrote a book one time. I need to get a hold of this. Well, I do think he's a fairly decent arbiter. I do not think he is the best arbiter. Not really, not close. I hate to say it, but the best arbiter in threes is Topher. Speaking of Topher, if you want to check out some more games against of me playing against Topher and Kibbles, we played some the other day. The games are on my past broadcast on my Twitch channel. Just type in Sangre Azteca MX, just like my YouTube channel and my gamer tag. Easy peasy. this game is basically over. I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.
All units. Victorious.